Hello, we'll see the nested if else. In nested if else, we have multiple blocks depending on condition. Suppose you have a scenario where you want to execute either block out of multiple blocks available. Like suppose for academics, so when you go to the academics, there is some range for first class. Like if the marks are between 60 to 70%, then first class. For 50 to 60%, second class, and so on. So there will be multiple conditions. So if those multiple conditions you want to give, you have to write nested if else. Syntax is shown here. So if first condition block for that if, then else if you will write. Else if second condition block for the second condition, then again else if block for the third condition and so on. Last else did not have the condition part. In the example, x value is 30, which is assigned. Condition is if x equals to 10, then it will print this thing. If it is 20, it will print this thing. If it is 30, then this statement is executed. So right now, the third condition is true. So this will give output as value of x is 30. So we will implement this nested if else practically. This is if else if statement. If you have multiple conditions and different implementation for each condition, then I will use this syntax. You can see the example x is 30. Now if x equals to 10, it is printing this statement. If x equals to 20, we'll print this statement. If x equals to 30, it will print another statement and so on. But why we are writing if, else if, else if? We can even do this thing by simply multiple if conditions. But in that case, all the if conditions will be checked though particular condition comes true or false, which is not necessary. In this case, the next condition will be checked only if the previous condition is false. So whenever condition becomes true, the execution will stop there. I will run the code. Right now the output is value of x is 30. So this was regarding the if else if statement.